Things looked extremely bright for the Third Gordian and his empire, at least for the first 2 years of his rule. This is from 238 to 240. The people liked him and his mother Gordiana. The Senate liked having a child as emperor, for his life and the government was on their hands, and everyone seemed content. Even the Praetorians didn't cause much trouble. There aren't any sources mentioning any events of certain interest except to acting the Carpi invasion I already explained. So it's easy to assume that in 240, the year of the six emperors had been already forgotten. However, the people of Carthage, who had made Gordian III's grandfather and uncle emperors in opposition to Maximinus Thrax, whom they called traitor and despot, now once again were mutineering, but this time against him. As always, the sources of this mutiny are extremely scarce, but we've at least gotten a name for the usurper, Marcus Asinius Sabinianus. There's not much to say about the proconsul's biography other than he must have held some consular position prior to him being sent to Africa, quite possibly a praetor. Regarding his family, the Asini, looking into their current whereabouts could help finding Marcus Asinius Sabinianus's origin and family. Following his name, it's very probable that he descended from Marcus Asinius Marcellus II, a descendant himself of Gaius Asinius Pollio, famous playwriter and politician of the late Republic. The gens Asinian was well established, being several of his members consuls and holding main government positions. It's hard to locate African proconsul Sabinianus's position in the consular ranks, but it's very clear he must have held some important positions before his rise. His father or grandfather could have been Marcus Asinius Rufinius Valerius Verus Sabinianus, who bears all three of his names. He was consul in an unknown year between 183 and 195, meaning that our protagonist could have surely had an advantageous beginning. I've also found a man named Marcus Triarius Rufinus Asinius Sabinianus, who had the governorship of Asia between 238 and 240 more or less, and that could be either African proconsul Sabinianus himself, or maybe a close relative of his. That's all I could muster regarding his family, so now let's move on to the actual usurpation attempt. I say attempt because, obviously, unlike his Gordian predecessors, he failed in getting real support from the Carthaginians. The reason cited for his usurpation was the dissolution of the Legio Tertia Augusta, the only legion stationed in Africa, for they had killed Gordian II. Seeing how there was no real threat near him, Sabinianus proclaimed himself emperor in Carthage, and the peoples of the African proconsulate fake support for him. Not much later, and following the example of Gordian II, he was defeated by the governor of Mauretania Caesariensis, but unlike the latter, he survived the battle, then to be either killed in Carthage when the citizens saw Caesonius Lucilius Macer Rutilianus arrive with an army to restore order, or simply handed over to the legitimate Roman authorities. Upon hearing of Sabinianus's revolt, Roman senator Caesonius had been awarded the proconsulship of Africa. Seeing how the Carthaginians had surrendered the traitor, they were granted mercy, and unlike Capellianus had done in 238, the city was not ravaged. The exact date of his defeat must have been at least later than October, having Zosimus cited that he was defeated nearing the end of the year. Curiously enough, this Caesonius had been one of the 20 men that elected Pupienus and Balbinus emperors in 238, certainly a man who had much power and definitely deserved being awarded the position of governor of Africa. What bugs me the most about this whole thing is the following, because I've not been able to find a name for the governor of Mauritania Caesariensis, and as I said, the local legion had been disbanded, I don't really know anything about the battle that took place between the usurper and the loyalist governor. They both could have been militias mixed with some local soldiers, the governors had garrisons, and there's also not a single mention of the battlefield, while there's plenty of mentions thanks to Herodian of the Battle of Carthage, which didn't really take place in Carthage proper. Of course, it's easy to assume that this unnamed battle was another conflict outside the main walls of the city, or maybe even a skirmish. It's really hard to know whether Sabinianus's defeat in this conflict made the Carthaginian elite surrender him to Caesonius, or if it was just the first nail in the coffin, being the arrival of the senator, the last one. Maybe there wasn't even a battle, and the historians are just saying that once the neighboring governor refused to join Sabinianus in his mutiny, maybe even marching against him with a minor contingent of soldiers, the Carthaginian populace just gave up. Proof of this could have been the lack of coins bearing Sabinianus's effigy, while the first two guardians, who just reigned for less than a month, had several made. This explains that the revolt was very quickly suppressed. And that would be all. A thorough repetition of the year 238 that ends up with the proconsul of Africa dead, killed by another governor. Or maybe not. Could Capellianus still have been governor in 240? I don't think so, having himself killed Gordian's uncle and grandfather, but still, it would be very ironic, don't you think? Protecting the one you sought to destroy.